Welcome back to Quick Lessons with Prachitik. In this video, we are going to see how to insert a node in a singly linked list. Basically, singly linked list is a sequence of elements in which every element has a link to the next element in the sequence. This is the example of a singly linked list. In a singly linked list, individual element is called as a node. Every node contains a two field, one is a data field and another one is a next field. Data field consists of actual value of the node, and the next field is used to store address of the next node in the sequence. Now let's see how to perform insertion operation in a singly linked list. So there are three ways you can insert any node in an existing linked list. The one is an insertion at the beginning of the list, second is an insertion at the end of the list, and third is an insertion at a specific location in the list. Okay, so now let's start with the first case, that is the insertion of a node at the beginning of the list. Suppose this is the node that you want to insert. Now first check whether the list is empty or not. That means first check whether the other nodes are present over there or not. If the nodes is not present, then in that case you have to make that new node, next field of that new node as a null, and make this node as a head node. Now second condition is, if the list is not empty, in that case suppose consider this linked list and this list is not empty as there are four nodes are already present, and suppose I want to insert this new node at the beginning of the list, then suppose this node is a X node. Now this is the new node, and if the list is not empty, then the next field of this new node, it points to the head, that is a head of existing list, and make this new node as a head node. So you can say if the list is empty, then new node of next is equal to null and head is equal to new node. And if the list is not empty, then new node of next will points to the head of the existing node and head becomes the new node. Now let's see the second case. The second case is insertion of a node at the end of the linked list. Now here again, first check whether the list is empty or not. Suppose this is your node, same like your previous case. If this is node and your linked list is an empty linked list, then you have to make the next field of this node as a null, and this head will point to this new node. Now second case is again if the list is not empty. Now means suppose this is the node that you want to insert at the end of your linked list. So in such cases, what we have to do is you have to define a pointer P and the head at this node or at the first node of your linked list. Now you have to keep moving this P pointer to the next node until it reaches to the last node. That means until P of next is null, you have to move this P pointer. Now suppose this pointer is here, first we will check the next field of this points to the null or not. If it is not points to the null, then that P pointer will move to this. Now again it will check whether that next field of this P pointer points to null or not. So as this node, it consists of address of this C data, that means which is not null, so it will again move to the next node. Now here again it will check whether it will point to the null or not. As it is not points to the null, it will again move to this node. Now here it will see that this field of this node is points to the null, as this is the last field in your linked list. So here is the position where you have to insert the new node. So in such cases, if suppose this is your new node, you will make the P of next is equal to new node. That means currently your pointer is here. So you have to make this next field of this node, which is point to this new node, and then you have to make the next field of this new node as a null. In short, what you can say is, while P of next is not null, you have to move this p pointer, that means p is equal to p of next. And when it is null, that means once you reach the last node in the linked list, you have to make p of next is equal to new node, and the new node of next is equal to null. Now let's see the third case. So the third case is insertion at a specific location in the list. Suppose you have to insert a node and the list is empty. Then in that case, same like a previous case, you have to write these two lines. New node of next is equal to null. That means you have to make that next field of that new node as a null, and you have to point that head to the new node. Now if the list is not empty. So if the list is not empty, you have to define a pointer p and head at this position. Then you have to keep moving this p to the next node until it reaches to the node after which you want to insert the new node. Suppose at this position you want to insert that new node. Data value of that node is x, and you want to insert this node at this position. But currently this next field of this c consists of address of this d. So but if you want to insert this node at this position, so c must consist of address of this x node. So for that purpose you have to make a one another pointer, that is a store next pointer. Into this store next pointer I will store the address of this d, which is present in a next field of this c. Okay, so for that purpose I have written here store next is equal to p of next. So as p is now here, and here it will getting that at this position he want to insert that new node. So that is why store next, which consists of address of this p of next, and then the p of next is equal to new node. That means this p of next field now points to this new node. So just delete this link between c and d and make new link that points to this x node, and then the next field of this x node must point to this d. Okay, so for that purpose I have written this line, p of next is equal to new node, and new node of next is equal to store next. So in short, you can say that while p is not equal to insert position, it can be any position, so you have to move this p pointer. So the p is equal to p of next, and if it is the insert position, then in that case you have to write store next is equal to p of next, then p of next is equal to new node, and new node of next is equal to store next. So these are the three cases or the three ways you can insert any new node into your existing linked list.